Hey everybody, and welcome to Schoolism Interviews, mini-series where we talk about art and life as an artist. I'm your host, Bobby Chiu. Victoria Ying is an incredible artist and educator that's worked in children's books, illustration, as well as animated films such as Tangled, Paper Man, Wreck-It Ralph, Frozen, Big Hero 6, and Moana. She's admired for her visual development art, and we are so honored to have her teach Introduction to Visual Development on schoolism.com. Now, without further ado, here's my interview with the incredible Victoria Ying. Please enjoy. Hi, Victoria. In your class, Introduction to Visual Development, your very last lesson is a super important one, portfolio design. Now that people have gone through the lessons in your class, hopefully they already have, can we talk a little bit about what you mean by portfolio design?
Absolutely. When I was in school, we kind of had this idea that there was like a perfect portfolio. There is one portfolio that you will make that will be perfect and everyone's going to respond to it the same way. And the thing that I've learned working with other artists and other recruiters and other studios is that that is absolutely not true. There is no one perfect portfolio, and that makes it really hard, right? Like, how do I actually make my portfolio? So like, this lesson is really about how do you ask yourselves the right questions in order to build this portfolio that's going to be the right reflection of yourself and is going to represent you the best, that isn't necessarily what everyone else is saying, like, oh, you need this number of, you know, landscape drawings and you need this many props and this many characters. Like, that's not at all what this is. Like, I'm anti-prescriptiveness in terms of portfolios, and what I am pro is very pro you. You know, like, I want you to like figure out what you want, where you want to be, and then I want to help you get there. So this is really, again, it's more about thinking. It's less about like, how do I actually like physically build a portfolio? And it's more about that basis of like, okay, how much do I have to actually think about what it is that I want in my life and where I want to be? And, you know, how do I actually fulfill that process of getting there?
Is there any kind of fundamental questions or tips that we can kind of give the audience to help them already?
Definitely. So my biggest tip is to look at art of books of the studios you're applying to, and to make sure that all of your portfolios are different. And this used to be a taller order when you had to print portfolios and send them. But now that we have PDFs, you know, it's so easy to build a new portfolio for every studio. So, you know, look at the art of books and figure out like, what are the values of the studios that you're applying to? Pixar is very different than DreamWorks. They're both animation studios and their end product is very similar. But if you look at their art of books, you'll see that their priorities are super, super different. And if you know that about the studio, then you're much more likely to be able to cater to them and give them a portfolio of work that they'll respond to.
Fantastic. I hope everybody checks out this class because I really love this lesson. I thought it was very valuable. If you're interested in knowing more about Victoria Ying's class, Introduction to Visual Development, visit schoolism.com.